Hello everyone.
Have a lovely day.
I hope we're having a good time.
It's not on. Is it on?
Woo!
Yeah. Is it on?
Yeah.
I hope we're having a good time. So I'm here to say to everyone, I have a good message.
Deflated, so
something that we need to think about.
Which and it says, take it from actually.
Don't bite the hand of the one that feeds you. I'll say it again. Do not bite the hand of the one that feeds you. So I listened to a story of an evangelist, and he went to the restaurant to eat with his wife. They had dinner, and they had a very good time, had a very good meal, and he couldn't finish his steak. So he took his steak home to give to the dog. And obviously, when he put the steak down for the dog to eat, the dog bit his hand. And that's similar to what we do. You know, we live in this world and we just, you know, do whatever we feel like doing. But we forget to give gratitude and honor to the one who gave us life. You know, the person who gave us life, we blaspheme his name, you know, we break all his rules, you know, and we don't think that, you know, there will be a consequence for that. Imagine if you did that to your, you know, gave something to your dog or gave something to your child and they don't show you any gratitude. How are you going to feel? You know, think of how God feels as well when we break his laws. And someone might think, what are the laws of God? What does God not like? We all know this because the Bible says that the laws of God are written in our hearts. No, the laws of God are written in our hearts, and we all know what we shouldn't do. So when we lie, we know that it's breaking God's rule for us to lie, you know, to our neighbor, to our friends, to our family, to our parents. We know it's not good. We know it's wrong to do that. But still, because we're rebellious against God, we do all these things. We know it's not good for us to hate anyone. And the Bible says anyone that hates anybody in his heart is like a murderer. That's what the Bible says. And we also know that it's not good to, you know, have sex with anybody we like. You know, in this world, people just call it having fun. But all these things have consequences apart from our soul, our mind that is broken when we go through all these rejections, all these heartbreaks. You know, if we follow God's law, everything will be good. If we follow God's law, think about it. The Bible says we should do unto others the way we want to be done to us. If everyone did that, there won't be any problem in this world. But because we have free will, we do what we like and we have consequences. The Bible says, it's appointed unto man once to die and after that judgment. So the question you need to ask yourself is, when God judges me for all the things I've done, how am I going to survive God's judgment? And if you're like me, who is a sinner, who have done bad things, you know that you're going to be guilty as charged. The question is, if you're guilty, if God judges you by his commandments, are you going to go to heaven or hell? By God's standard and by God's laws, he says, all sin will be punished. All liars will have their parts in the lake of fire, which burns with brimstone. So that means we are inexcusable. The Bible says, oh man, you are inexcusable. So what can you do? If God judges you by his 10 commandments, what are you going to do? How are you going to escape this judgment? We know we can't escape it because God is so holy that he cannot ignore sin. But also he's so loving that he doesn't want you to go to hell. So what is he going to do? He's not going to ignore your sins. So what is he going to do? Now this is what the loving God did. He actually came down himself to pay the price for our sins. And that's the person we call Jesus Christ. The Bible says he's the visible image of the invisible God. If God wants to have a relationship with you, how is he going to do it? If he's a spirit and you can't see him, he had to come down as a human being. And that's the person we call Jesus Christ. So he died on the cross 2,000 years ago for our sins, and when he died, he said, it is finished. That means your sins have been paid for. It is finished. So what do you have to do right now? What you need to do is acknowledge you're a sinner. Don't be like, you know, it doesn't matter. Oh, I just sinned again. I just offended this person. It's just between me and him. It's also against God. Any bad thing you do, any ill, bad thoughts you've thought about anybody is against God, and he's going to judge it. So the Bible says that Christ has paid the price for our sins. All we need to do is acknowledge that we are sinners and we've broken God's laws and we are doomed to go to hell for our sins, and repent. Repentance means being sorry for your sins and turning away from it. And once you repent, turn away from your sins and put your trust on Christ, the Bible promises that you're going to have everlasting life as a free gift. God is going to forgive your sins and will never remember them anymore. He says he will throw them into the sea of forgetfulness. Like the east is to the west, he's not going to remember your sins anymore. So right now, all you need to do, wherever you are, is to say to God, Father, I'm really sorry for my sins. Please forgive me. And he's faithful and able to forgive you to the uttermost. He's going to forgive you and cleanse you from all your sins. And you become his child. So now when you meet God, when you die, he's not going to see your sins anymore, because he's going to see the payment of Christ. He's going to see the righteousness of Christ. Because the Bible says we have the righteousness of Christ. So God is going to forgive you and you become his child. Any sin you've committed, God is going to forgive you. You might think that you've done numerous sins, you've committed atrocities, you've committed everything. But there's no sin that is bigger than God. There's no sin that God cannot forgive. There is no sin, I repeat it again, there is no sin that God cannot forgive.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what it is. Yes. There is no sin that God cannot forgive. He promises to forgive every sin and welcome you with his open arms and embrace you, and you become his child. And that's what the Bible calls being born again. You're born here, you know, as a human being, but your heart is regenerated. You start loving what is good, what God loves, and start hating what God hates. You start living a righteous life because God has regenerated your life. So again, I'm going to call, the Bible says that God commands everyone everywhere to repent and put their trust in Christ. That's all you need to do. You don't need to actually be religious about it. Just say a little prayer wherever you are and say, God, I'm really sorry for my sins. Cleanse me from all my unrighteousness and put your Holy Spirit in me. And God promises that he's going to cleanse you from all unrighteousness and you become his child. And you have everlasting life as a free gift. So thank you everyone for listening, for listening to me. I hope you put this into consideration. Think about this. Don't get too carried away with the activities of the world and forget where you're going to spend eternity. Thank you very much and God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen.